Are you serious? Are you serious, folks? We have breaking news right now. I want to thank really want to thank Alan down there in Texas for this. Here we go. Four cargo. You heard me. Four cargo ships. Excuse me. Four cargo ships have been sabotaged on today near the United Arab Emirates in the Gulf of Oman. And the UAE foreign ministry said that in... it's been reported, though, that there was some harmful chemicals and fuel that had occurred. But now here's what they're really concerned about. They're very concerned about the fact that we have 7 to 10 oil tankers are in flames off the coast of the United Arab Emirates. Currently, right now, the U.S. and French warplanes are flying overhead and have at the same time. They're saying that this is, of course, the United Arab Emirates is currently expanding the port to hold the world's largest crude oil storage facility capable of storing up to 14 million barrels of oil. According to reports by DEPCA's military and intelligence sources, report that the United Arab Emirates ministry statement conceals more than it reveals, but it is obvious that someone in the Gulf region has launched an attack on oil and gas shipping in the region. 7 to 10 different oil tankers are up in flames right now. It is hardly to be doubted that the aggression in this case was probably Iran or one of its allies or proxies, Tehran's first major reprisal for U.S. sanctions. As they have been warning, they have been indicating that, and there had been reports, intelligence reports, that Iran was going to strike, that they were going to strike the oil industry if the United States did not back off their sanctions by yesterday, the 11th. So today is the 12th, and we have this report. Now, while that's going on, I have another report. I want to thank Heidi for this, as she has just brought forward the fact that we have several, give me 1 second to find this report. Okay, here it is. All right. Again, the United Arab Emirates, what we have now is fire has erupted. There's three different vehicles that are on fire that were parked at a metro station this morning in the United Arab Emirates, leaving a plume of black smoke hovering across the city's skyline. According to reports, the firefighters from Port Said are reporting they're trying to put out the blaze. The fire was initially caused by three vehicles parked near a warehouse. All three were set on fire. And, of course, the warehouse also caught on fire. And then we still don't have any reports of injuries. It is too early to tell what exactly is taking place there. But somebody has attacked 7 to 10 oil tankers off the coast of the United Arab Emirates. 7 to 10 oil tankers in flames. But now the UAE said they at first had denied that there was any heavy explosions at this port, but United States and French warplanes flying overhead at the same time have identified 7 to 10 oil tankers are going up in smoke in flames off the coast of the United Arab Emirates there near Oman, okay? And also, four other cargo ships were hit by a sabotage operations. And I'm not sure, we still don't know if those four ships that were hit with sabotage, are they part of the 7 to 10 tankers that are in flames off the coast of the United Arab Emirates? And that's not too far, across the coast of Oman. You're getting down in that area near the Arabian Sea, near the Straits of Hormuz. You're in that neighborhood there where a lot of oil has to go through there. So we're going to keep a close eye on all this. You don't want to miss tonight's Sunday Night Live broadcast. My guest will be joining me live here from the road. We just finished up the Cincinnati conference yesterday, which was phenomenal. We're going to share some of that information with you tonight. Stephen Bendenoon will be with me, joining me here in the hotel live on Sunday Night Live. I'll see you at 7 p.m. Eastern. I want to thank Heidi for getting this information to me and Alan down there in Texas. I'll be back with more in just a moment.